Praise the Lord and good evening. Once again, this is another Sunday, ni Jumapili ingine. Jina langu ni Bishop Maina, na mimi ni pastor na shepherd wa kanisa la Ebenezer Grace International. Na kanisa letu liko Baraka, pande huu wa Molem katika jiji hili letu la Nairobi. Tuwapenda wageni na kwa hivyo na shukua nafasi hii ni wakarimbishe kama wewe ni mkaaji wa sehemu hiyo ya Baraka. Tuwapenda wageni, kila Jumapili tunakuwa na wakati wa kumwabudu Mungu, kulisikiliza neno lake. Tuna ibada mbili siku ya Jumapili kuanzia saa 3 hadi saa 7. Na kwa hivyo kama unaishi katika maeneo hayo, twakukaribisha katika jina la Yesu. Na katikati ya wiki kuanzia siku ya Jumatatu, Jumanne, Jumatano na Alhamisi, siku hizo nne tunakutanika kila jioni kuanzia saa 12 na tunazungumza neno la Mungu, tunalitafakari neno la Mungu pamoja na tunasikiliza jinsi Mungu anapenda tuishi na hata kutubariki katika maisha haya ya imani. Na kwa hivyo kama una jambo unaweza kututembelea huko kwetu na tunaweza kusungumza pamoja. Jioni hii ya leo ni wakati mwingine nikiwakaribisha watazamaji wangu nyinyi wote kila mahali mlipo. Neema zake Mungu zimetutosha, ametuleta tena jioni hii ili tuendelee na neno lake, maana inampendeza tufahamu mawazo yake na tufahamu neno lake lasema nini kutuhusu sisi wanae naye akiwa Baba wetu wa binguni. Na kwa hivyo ninataka tuendelee kutoka mahali pale pale tulimalizia last week ili tupate kuendelea na tuone jinsi Mungu anataka tuone siku hii ya leo. Na ninataka nisome neno alafu niombe na tupate kuendelea pamoja katika jina lake Kristo Yesu. Tulisoma Deuteronomy chapter number 28 and verse number 13 and 14. And these were the cautioning words that Moses spoke to the assembly of Israelites. And he wanted to remind them on what God expected of them as his chosen people or nation, on how to worship him, on how to love him, and on how to obey and serve him. And Moses kept on reminding the nation of Israel that these are the expectation of God, and these are the promises, the blessings that God has kept for you. And chapter number 28, right from verse 1, it speaks about the blessings. The God who is the keeper of covenant had promised the nation of Israel. But in a cautioning moment, Moses reminded them of the consequences, and we are going to see right along. In verse number 13, he says, "And the Lord will make you the head and not the tail. You shall be above only and not beneath. If you heed the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command you today, and are careful to observe them, so you shall not turn aside from any of the words which I command you this day, to the right or the left, to go after other gods to serve them." Those were the last words that we read together. And I want to pick from there where we left it last Sunday. These were the cautioning words to the nation of Israel, that you be careful not to divert from the path that God has made for you, from his ways, from his words, from his commandments, He had set them and made them plain through his servant Moses, and who kept on reminding them every moment that he had the opportunity to share with them that these are the expectation of God, your sustainer, your protector, who will provide for your needs. And I want to remind the viewers that the Israelites went through very harsh conditions through the wilderness. No place to live in, no cloud to cultivate, no business to do in the wilderness. But God kept his word. He will be their refuge. He will be their sustainer. He will carry them in the day and in the night, during the harsh conditions of the day. It's sunny. It's hot, extremely hot in the desert. By the night, it is extremely cold. But God was their sustainer. God provided for their daily needs. They lacked nothing in their journey through those harsh conditions of the desert. God provided them all that they needed. He protected them. He carried them under his wings like chicken carries the chicken, or protect the chicks. That's how God did with the nation of Israel. And Moses kept on reminding them, this is your father who cares for you. This is your God who brought you out from the land of bondage in Egypt. You should love him. You should worship him. You should serve him. Those were the expectations of God. And Moses kept on reminding them on those words and what God expected of them. And verse number 14 said, serve not other gods. Worship. Don't go for other gods. Don't neglect the worship of Yahweh. And I'm sure these words are speaking for him. They are speaking to you and to me. The experiences that the nation of Israel went through, or that happened to the nation of Israel from Egypt all the way through Canaan, was a shadow, a reflection for us to see what God does with his people and who is a keeper of his promises, his covenants, and also a shadow of the church of today, and how God maintained his word then. He will do it even today. How God provided for the church, the nation of Israel in the desert, he will do it today. How he carried them through the harsh conditions, he will do the same for us, the believers, the church, even today. He is the same God, the keeper of covenants, his word. He never regrets. He never repents. He keeps those promises for his people. And we are going to see that when God demanded Israel to walk in his ways, Deuteronomy chapter number 10, let's go there quickly and see what God is saying and reminding. These are the same ones that he kept on reminding. In verse number 12, he says, God demanded Israel to walk. And now, Israel, what does the Lord your God require of you? But to fear the Lord your God, to walk in all his ways, and to love him, to serve the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Those were the expectations that he, the Israelites, to walk in his way, to love him and serve him. Three things: walk in his ways, love him, and serve him. No other God, no other idol worship, serving idol worship, no, but to serve him and him alone. And in Psalms 119 and verse 3, and it repeats the same words, that you do not iniquity, do not sin. And this is what is expected of you and even of me today, that we who are called and redeemed of the Lord, he expects us to live a holy life because he is a holy God. Be righteous because he is righteous. And keep his word, that keep on cleansing us, sanctify us, and making us holy in his presence. And in Jeremiah 7 and 23, this is what the voice of God, or the word of God, is saying. Obey his voice. Obey his word. Jeremiah is reminding again the nation of Israel on obeying God's word, that he continued to be their refuge, to be their provider, to be their sustainer, and to live a prolonged life and walk also in his way. But Israel was pushed from every side. They lived among the heathen, the Gentiles, and they were pushing them, and they were living among or in the neighborhood of these Gentiles, or walking or living solely among those Gentiles. And in Deuteronomy chapter number 32, I want to share a little bit with you. Deuteronomy chapter number 32, we see what Israel did. And verse number 5, this is the song of Moses, and it speaks about the consequences and how the nation of Israel compromised on their faith. They looked into other gods and worshipped them. They didn't continue worshipping Yahweh. They disobeyed him and no longer loved him, no longer served him. And this is what Moses is saying. Verse number 5. They have corrupted themselves. The Israelites corrupted themselves by the way they indulged into the worship of other gods. And they neglected the worship of Yahweh. They turned their allegiance to other gods. They no longer continued loving Yahweh and serving him. And this is what Moses is saying. They are not his children. They turned their back now on God. They no longer looked at him as God who brought them, their fathers, from the land of bondage through the wilderness, calling them day and night, sustaining them. But they now have neglected the worship of Yahweh. They are no longer his children. Because of their blemish, they polluted their faith. They were corrupted in their faith by the worship of other gods and the ways, living the ways of the Gentiles. And it continues saying, it is a perverse and crooked generation. And verse number 6 continues to say, do you thus deal with the Lord, O foolish and unwise people? Is he not your father who brought you? Has he not made you and established you? These are very important questions that Moses is asking the nation of Israel. And these words are also speaking to us, the church and the believers of today. Through what we read last week, the moments that we are living in, very harsh and difficult times. There are people who are living and not having anything to eat because of lack. Economically, we all have seen how our nation is going through the situation that we are going through of the COVID 19. There are very hard moments and experiences that our people have gone through. We have losses in many or most of the homes. Either losses because you have lost a friend, you have lost a parent, you have lost a job, you have lost a business, and people are being traumatized. These are very difficult moments that we are all going through. And believers in the church is not spared. We are all in it. But God has promised to be our sustainer. This is God's word that he will be our refuge. He will walk with us even in those harsh and difficult moments of our life. He will not leave us. So he expects us to keep our walk and not to neglect his worship and to continue loving him and walking his way no matter what test and times that we are going through. In verse number 17, the word continue to say, they sacrificed demons, not to God. To gods they did not know, to new gods, new arrivals that your fathers did not fear. Verse number 18, of the Lord who begot you, you are unmindful. They didn't care about Yahweh. They neglected him. They didn't worship anymore. They didn't follow him. They didn't walk in his ways. This is what Moses, and have forgotten the God who fathered you. These are difficult words even to think about. And they are speaking to us today. And we have questions to ask ourselves. Are we going to lower our standards? Are we going to lower our values? Are we going to turn to the fleeting, sinful world? Are we going to turn to the things of this world that are enticing us and pulling us? Are we going to be corrupted by the wealth, the riches of this world, and neglect the worship of our Lord and following his way, walking in his ways? And these are the questions that the church and every believer need to ask ourselves as we look on the reflection on the nation of Israel. Despite being redeemed from Egypt, being carried through harsh conditions through the desert, and God kept his word, sustained them, protected them, and protected them, provided for them in every walk, in every moment of their life. His presence and his glory was with them. And I'm sure God has been the same to you since you yielded to Jesus as your Lord and your Savior. I'm sure God has been gracious to you. And even during the time of test, as we are all going through these difficult moments and times that we are experiencing today, God is reminding us through this word, He is still our Father. And He expects you, no matter what you are going through, to keep your love for Him and to obey Him, to serve Him, to worship Him, and walk in His way. This is the standard that God is expecting of you and expecting of the church today and expecting of every believer. Just as Israel never kept the word, they never kept the faith. It is the same. The same consequences can happen to you, can happen to us. And before we reach there, God is cautioning us to be careful not to leave His way, not to turn to the light and turn our attention to the systems of this world and worship them and leave them. No, He is expecting of us to leave His word and to walk His word and to worship Him all the moment, because He is a jealous God and He deserves our absolute attention, our absolute love, service and worship at all time. I want to turn to another reflection. Want to lean together this evening concerning the church of Pergamos. And I want us to turn to the book of Revelation. There are some cautioning words there that I want to lay the foundation as we continue with the series. Let's never compromise your faith. And I want to turn to the book of Revelation chapter number 2. Revelation chapter number 2. And we are going to read verses number 12 and up to 15. And now read. And to the angel of the church of Pergamos write, this thing says he who has the sharp two-edged sword, I know your works, and where you dwell, where Satan's throne is, and you hold fast to my name, and did not deny my faith even in the days in which Antipas was my faithful martyr. These are the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the believers in the city of Pergamos, they went through persecution. They went through testing moments of their faith. But Jesus is saying, you never let down your guard. You never wavered. You continued being firm, unshakable in your faith, despite the environment that you are living in, despite the persecutions that you went through. But it continues to say, the word of God continues to say, but I have a few things against you. Verse number 14. Because you have there those who hold the doctrine of Balaam, who taught Balak to put a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed to idols, and to commit sexual immorality. Thus, you also have those who hold the doctrine of the Nicolaitans, which thing I hate. These are the words of our Lord Jesus Christ that He spoke to the church of Pergamos. And they are words of cautioning And they are allotting words on their position, on their faith. He recommended them for not letting down their guards and keeping the faith despite the persecutions. And even despite their city being the city or the dwelling of Satan. But they kept rooted. They were rooted in the word of God. They were well grounded in the faith. But he still held a caution because of some elements in the church. Some men and women who never kept the faith, who lowered their values, who lowered their standards, and they gave in to the enticing teachings and the philosophies of Balaam and Nicholas, the doctrine, the heresy of Nicholas. And Jesus is speaking to them to arise from their slumber, to leave their idol worship, to leave their sexual immorality. Mind you, he is talking to the church. There are those elements, there are those men and women in the church who are after the teachings of Balaam, abstaining or leaving the worship of Yahweh, of God, and now turning to the sexual immorality, to idol worship. And we have some words in Acts chapter number 15 and verse 22 that they speak also on the same values, the Christian values, and cautioning words to the believers. As Jesus continued even to speak to this church in Pergamum, that they have left his worship, they have left loving him, they are left walking in his ways, and now they have been seduced by the teachings of Balaam. They have been pulled by and seduced into the worship of idol and serving other gods, into immorality. And this is what was taking place in the church in Pergamum. And in Acts chapter number 15 and verse 20, there was this council in Jerusalem which wrote a telling letter to the brethren, to the Gentiles, brethren, on how to walk in the new faith and how to live in the new faith and leave the past, the worship of idol, the sexual immorality, the sinful life that they were living, and the things they have to live now that they are in the new faith, in order to live as expectant of the word of God. And they wrote and said this to the brethren, the Gentile brethren, abstain from things that are polluted by idols and even sexual immorality. And these are the same words. This is the same message that Jesus was talking and giving to the church in Pergamum. And these words are telling something to us. They are telling. They are speaking to us. It is possible even in our churches. We have men and women whose faith is cold, lukewarm. They are turning their attention to the enticing philosophies of men and teachings of men. They are being seduced from the faith into immorality, seduced from the worship of God into idol worship, and paying attention to temporal things that have no value. They are just for a moment. They are not internal. And God is giving a message, words of caution to the church as we see the reflection now through the church in Pergamos. The same that was happening in this church could be happening even in our midst, that we have some brethren who have been seduced into the worship of idol. They have left the first love, the first worship of their God. They have disobeyed God's word and turned their back on Him, and they are yielding to the fleeting, sinful things of this world that are pulling them, seducing them into and leaving the worship of God. I'm sorry. And now God is speaking to this church that you have left the first love. You have left the worship. And He is cautioning them, leave that kind of life. And this is what the word of God is telling even to us this evening, that we leave the idol worship, that we leave the sexual immorality and turn our attention once again to God. Leave those evil things that don't go along with the word of God and have seduced us from the worship of God. And we have turned our attention from the love of God to the love of the things of this world, the material things, the wealth of this world, the systems of this world. We have embraced them and have neglected the first love. I want to ask to go on and see some other words in the same chapter. Let's read verse number 18. And now the angel, and to the angel of the church of the Thyatira write these things. They are cautioning words that we need to think about them, that we be careful not to live like them, but change our life and change our standards, not lower our standards, our values, our Christian faith, but live as the word of God tells us. These things says the Son of God, who has the eyes like a flame of fire, and His feet like fine brass. I know your works, love, service, faith, and your patience. And as for your works, the last are more than the first. Nevertheless, I have a few things against you, because you allow that woman Jezebel, who calls herself a prophetess, to teach and seduce My servants commit sexual immorality and eat things sacrificed to idols. These are words that Jesus spoke to the church in Thyatira. And the words that are speaking to us today on what would fall on us as believers, on what can happen to the church today if we lower our values, if we neglect the worship of our Lord, if we fail to walk His ways and live His word, if we don't obey His voice, then these are the things that would fall on us as believers. We will not be spared by our enemy and the forces that are seducing us, and even from the power that we are encountering, that we are fighting against in our walk of faith. We need to be well grounded in faith, in the word of God, and never lower our standards, but keep on being elevated, keep on growing from strength to strength, from one level to another level. Keep on focusing on God's words and His calling. And when we are immersed in His word, we will not compromise on our faith. We will not compromise on our values, on our beliefs. The word will carry us. The word will protect us. But when we neglect the word of God, then we have no protection of our lives. We are left naked, prone to the enemies. And we can be attacked in a moment of our time. And we have no strength, no power of our own to fight the forces of evil. We need the power of the word of God. We need the strength of the word in order to overcome the evil forces that are always seducing us, trying to pull us from the worship of God, from living the word of God, walking in His way, keeping His word, and following His, obeying His voice. There are those forces, evil forces, that are pulling us, seducing us, the things of this world, the world of this world. They are a trap when we are not careful. Those traps will catch you. Those traps will catch you. But you be careful, as the word is cautioning us. Be awake. Look to your God. Follow His voice. Listen to what He is saying. And you are not going to give or yield to the seducing forces in this world. This is what happened to the church in Thyatira. There were those who allowed themselves. They listened to the seducing forces of Jezebel. And God is warning us not to yield to those forces, not to yield those words from Jezebel, who is pulling us, the evil one, who is seducing us into morality, who is seducing us to neglect the worship of our God, into the worship of the wealth, into the worship of properties, into the worship of idols, exalting not God anymore, but the things that are temporal. They are kipambere, they are the priorities in our life. We neglect assembling together. We neglect listening to the voice of God. We neglect hearing the word of God and turning to those voices. My friend, these are the cautioning words of God. Listen to what God is saying. He needs your love for Him. He needs you to worship Him. He needs you to obey to His voice. Live and walk in His word. And He has promised to be your God, to be your Father, to be your provider, to be your sustainer. I want to pray with you as we close our service this evening. I want to remember you as we go these harsh moments, living in the midst of the seducing evil forces. But I want to assure you through the word of God, God is your sustainer. God is your provider. Father, we thank you for every listener. Thank you for every viewer. We commit them into your able hands. As we continue listening to your voice, speaking to us through your word. No matter what tests they are going through, hard and harsh experiences they're going through, your word remains sure and true even today. You are our Father. You are our God. You are our refuge. You are our sustainer. Even through these experiences we are all going through, you have promised to walk with us, to provide for us, to sustain us. And those viewers, Lord, who are listening to this word, they are calling on you, the Father who never changes, who is their refuge, sustainer. I'm praying together with them that you provide for them, that you sustain them, that you protect them, that you carry them even through the harsh and difficult experiences that you are going through. Father, I thank you for your word. And I thank you for every listener, and thank you for every viewer. To you I commit them in your blessed hands. Amen. Thank you so much for listening. Till next Sunday, say shalom, shalom. God bless you. If you have anything that you want to share with us, you can use the number that is on your TV. You can ask any question. You can call us. And once again, we welcome you next Sunday. Till then, goodbye and God bless you.